Namaste. In Ayurveda, just important as passing these tools, we have in total 13 natural urges that we should respect in order to be healthy. In our Western culture, it's not well educated to yawn during some public things. In Ayurveda, if you're a suppressor or yawn, you're going to be sick. Just as if you suppress your urine, if you suppress the passing of gases, flatus, if you suppress the need to sneeze, if you suppress your thirst, if you suppress your hunger, your sleep, your need to cook, need to cry, to vomit, to discharge seminal fluid, and also the need to breathe heavily and deeply after some strong exercise, just like when you're running to some meeting and when you arrive there, you just like don't breathe deep because you feel that it's going to be not polite. So there are 13 Vegas, just like Las Vegas, that are important to keep your health on the track. This means, just as we spoke about the Vegas, about eat when you're hungry and do not eat when you're not hungry. The Vegas of going to the bathroom to release stools, to release urine. Here it doesn't appear the need to release the sweat. It's also a metabolic urge, but your body usually don't have the just like exact time to do this. But in very cold places, people have to arrange one way to sweat, just like the sauna of the Nordic countries and this kind of stuff. The point is that we have in Ayurveda natural movement of life force in our body, and they correct some metabolic systems. In Ayurveda, if we don't attend to these natural urges, our metabolic systems are going to be hampered during this blockage. And the life force that is going inside us is going to be just like, I'm not willing to come back here anymore. The point is that if we are always going against our natural urge of sleep, like 1 hour, 2 hours after the sunset, our body is pre-programmed to go to sleep, like we spoke in the first video about rhythm and the natural cycle of the sun and the life process in Earth for animals that are regulated mainly from the sun, not from the moon. So if we go against our need to sleep in the night, after some time our body is going to lose the rhythm of sleeping and is going to have a lot of problems of sleeping very swallow sleep, not having the sensation of being deeply rested. If we always are working and don't have the time to get up and go to the bathroom to micturate, and we think this is wrong because we need to work or the boss is going to fire and this kind of stuff, there is going to be some urinary infections in your body. If you don't sneeze properly when you feel, this is going to start to make some problems in your sinus, in your breathing system. The point is that in Ayurveda, we are still animals. Despite our etiquette of the French and this kind of westernized concepts. There is also one Vega that is not here, that is the necessity to pass the air from the mouth when we are bloating, just like when you're feeling full and like Homer Simpson. This can be the Homer Vega. All this kind of movement releases some tension from our metabolic physiology, and it makes it again into its natural functioning. In the West, we try not to be animals anymore. We think that it's impolite to pass gases. I'm not saying that you should do just like in the table where everyone is dining. But the point is that if it happens, in Ayurveda, you don't need to be ashamed of it. You're still an animal being. At least your body is still like this. In Ayurveda, we are not supposed to be like guilty or ashamed about the things that our body do when we are a baby. If we do some things just as a baby, probably your health is going to be on the track, because it's still regulated by the natural rhythm, the natural flux. This doesn't mean that you have to be just like pooping all the places and not using the toilet. Understand well what we're speaking here. The point is that in Western culture, much of the times, people don't pay attention to these natural urges. And these make people sick. It can be sleep, it can be not eating when it's hungry, not drinking water when it's thirsty, because there is a lot of because it's not polite, because it's not proper, because you're going to get fired, because you need to work, because of this, because of that. And we start to feel that we are machines in an industry that we don't need to be human beings, okay? Please remember, you're still a human being. And this means that you still have some natural urges that should not be neglected. There is also the concept in, like, maybe some tantra practice, Taoist practice of sexual relations, that the human, in this case the male semen, should not be ejaculated. Well, the point is that in Ayurveda also there is a kind of yogic training to transform this energy inside in ojas, in more subtle forms of immunity and grace inside. But the point is, we're going to speak about this concept in the next video, don't worry. The point is that if you're having sexual relation, and during the time of the sexual relation, you're having the urge to ejaculate, and you're just like saying, no, this is wrong, I learned in my this and that classes that it was going to spoil my health, this kind of stuff, probably you're going to make your reproductive system suffer. In Ayurveda, the human body, in an adult phase, the male body, it's developed to produce semen in a regular basis. And when the scrotum is full, it's programmed to release it, okay? It does not necessarily need to be an orgasm, but it needs to be ejaculation. In Ayurveda, orgasm and ejaculation are not actually the same thing. We are going to talk more about this when you're speaking about this concept of ojas in the next video. But the point is that if we pay attention to these 13 natural urges, let it say again, to pass the gases, this we can sum up the gases from the anus or from the mouth, to pass the feces, 2, the urine, 3, to sneeze, 4, to drink water, 5, to eat food, 6, to sleep, 7, to cough, 8, to breathe heavily on exertion, 9, to yawn, 10, to cry, 11, to vomit, 12, to discharge seminal fluid, 13, There are some people say about blink when you're needing, and today this is very important because there is a lot of use of computers and this kind of stuff. But the point is that it's the core behind all these dots is our body as a baby have some natural mechanisms to reconstruct itself. We call this vagus. These are not psychological needs, these are physiological needs. And we need to respect them in order that our health are not hampered. Because each one of these natural urges, if it's blocked, it starts to unbalance our physiological system. There is clinical description of diseases that come from each of these blockages. Here we are not going to detail this because this is more advanced topic and it's not the point here. The point to remember is just simple, very simple. Respect your body. It's an animal machine, not a steel machine. And it needs to maintain the rhythm. All the time that you block this rhythm, you're going to decrease the capacity of the body to turn on these faculties, and these are going to be forgotten by our inner system of coordination. Okay? You don't need now to say Vata this and that, but if you know a little bit of Ayurveda and you're thinking about these terms, okay also. So now we still have some more basic concepts to go on, but I hope that you're understanding that Ayurveda is a very simple but also very clever manner to manage your health daily in a simple manner. Okay? Once more, please, if you wanna have online consultations and this kind of stuff, just contact me at namaste.tiago@gmail.com. If you wanna subscribe, share this video and all the things you want, just do it. Namaste.